Would reach the pavement, he's been hiding from his razor. Is he not an awful sight? In love he was the purest, he's frightening the tourists. If he'd only asked his father, well, I'm sure he'd set him right. Well, he met her at a disco and a dive in San Francisco, and you know it would have been better had he'd seen her in daylight. She was painted, she was scented, she drove your man demented. If he'd gone and asked his father, well, I'm sure he'd set him right. So take her in your arms and tell her that you love her. Take her in your arms and hold that woman tight. Take her in your arms and tell her that you love her. If you're going to love a woman, then be sure and do it right. Not a million laughs and suicide's too dangerous. Don't go leaping out of buildings in the middle of the night. It's not the falling, but the landing will alter social standing. So go first and ask your father, and I'm sure he'll set you right. So take her in your arms and tell her that you love her. Take her in your arms and hold that woman tight. Take her in your arms.
All right, stay down. Just a thing to keep an eye pulling on. Taking all requests, as you might have guessed, he's a man thousands more. Oh, oh, he's a man of thousands more.
There's dancing, so go first and ask your father, and I'm sure he'll set you right. So take her in your arms and tell her that you love her. Take her in.
Look at that. Live from St. John's. It is.
You're going to the iguana. Then
be sure to do it right.
So take her in your arms. Take her in your arms and hold that woman tight. Take her in your arms and tell her that you love her. If you're going to love a woman, then be sure and do it right. If you're going to love a woman, then be sure and do it right.
As I rambled to the land wash below, I saw a fair maiden before me did go. She had a fine figure and long golden hair, and her clothes were as pretty as any would wear. Up to her I sauntered and boldly did say, "You're the fairest young woman I've seen in the bay. You are a fair maiden and the meadow is dry. Will you stroll along with me and in the grass lie?" "Oh no, sir," she answered with a toss of her head. "Before I lie with you, I'd rather be dead. I'm a merchant's own daughter of quite high degree. You may look from a distance, but never touch me." So I filled her with tales and I filled her with lies. I told her me clothes were but some disguise, to find a fair maiden who held her degree above lying in meadows with scoundrels like me. To the meadow we walked and in the grass lay, and to one another soft words we did say. "Your touch is quite gentle," she said unto me. "You becomes a fine young man of gentle degree." One day as I rambled, I met her close by. "I've a secret to tell you," she said with a sigh. "Your baby this winter will surely be born, and I want you to marry and save me from scorn." "I've a secret for you too," I said without joy. "I am nothing more than a fisherman's boy, And the baby who carries nothing to me, for his father is surely of higher degree.
Comes back. now I've got a horse there for us. How are you doing tonight? Jeff, good to see you, buddy. Good to see you making it on down.
Beep.